Hey guys, Robey here with another Divi tutorial, but actually this one might even be a WordPress tutorial. Yeah, I guess I'm doing some of those now too. I am going to be demonstrating how to add an Apple Liquid Class effect to your Divi UI. Now, the core principles will kind of be the same. You kind of see a preview of the effect that I have running right here. And I am going to be demonstrating what I like to call the poor man's version of the Liquid Class effect, because this is only utilizing some CSS and an SVG filter, and I will kind of tease a more advanced way of doing this that looks much better. But you know, Liquid Glass is probably not the best application, and this is just Apple doing the most Apple thing ever, which is change the UI and give it a fancy name and market it as a feature. But your client's going to be asking about this, so I'm going to show you two ways to do it. The one is in this video, and the better way will be in another video. Again, not the best UI decision, but I'm gonna show you how to do it anyway. So let's go. All right, guys, so here we go. I am on my Divi site with this poor man's glass effect applied. And as you can see, it kind of like warps on the edges here. It's not perfect by any means. You probably saw the announcement by Apple yourself. So, but it's also probably a terrible UI decision, because as you can see, things kind of get lost when the background kind of changes a bit. I applied some, a hover gradient here that black with some opacity to make the text a little bit more legible. And then also I went with darker colors on these hovers with this sticky element. But yeah, not the best idea, but we're going to do it anyway. So I have here what I wanted to show you, an article that I found this method on, and it did take some, swindling and adapting, but I am not the CSS expert. You guys know this. I just find the things and then figure out a way to make it work with Divi. You can see all these other methods, there's 11 of them. Most of them are utilizing CSS and some sort of SVG filter. And then other ones are a little bit more advanced, which is another way I'll show you how to do in a different video, by utilizing some WebGL and some shaders, as well as a cool library. And that's going to be that. So why don't we go ahead and jump into the back end of my Divi site here. So here I've got that layout. And this, of course, is the one with the applied code and stuff. And then I'm also going to be linking you guys to all the code snippets. So don't worry, that will all be linked here in the description of the video. So you can just go copy and paste these things. It's got some basic instructions in there for you, and that makes life easy. So let's go. Here's a normal Divi layout where you can see the effect has not been applied. And here is the visual builder. Now, we're going to be doing this by adding two code modules. One's going to be for some CSS code that you need to add. And then another one that is going to be the SVG filter that that CSS code utilizes. But before we do that, I will just quickly run over this sticky menu that I have here and just make sure everybody knows how to do this. Get this to be sticky at the bottom like that. All you got to do is go to your row. You're going to go to advanced and then you go and select position. The position is fixed, as it will be fixed on my screen in that location. And then I selected the bottom center. And now you're obviously maybe going to have to play with this a little bit to decide where on your screen that menu lies. I like mine right about there-ish, and that's perfect for me. And you want the Z index to be high because you want this to sit on top of the other content on the page. Now, can you do this with CSS? Of course you can. But since we're in Divi land, let's do it the Divi way. So I'm going to go ahead and just leave that as is. So I mentioned two code modules that we're going to be adding. So you can do that in this view, and it doesn't really matter where you place them. But I'm just going to go ahead and type in code here. Got my code module, and then I'm going to hop over to the code I can just copy and paste. So first one is this CSS code that we're going to need. And of course, you want to put that between two style tags. If you're doing this on the page, if you do this in the Divi theme options, you're not going to have to worry about that. But here we go. So in broad terms, let me make this a bit bigger for us so that we can get our eyeballs on it. Okay, so here we've got the base wrapper. So what we do is we wrap the area to which the glass effect is to be applied in a wrapper. And this tells the browser, okay, well, this is where this effect's going to get applied In the second part here, in the before, we're talking about the distortion effect, which is going to be the filter, the SVG filter that we create. And we're going to do that in a little bit. And that one's called DE Glass Distortion. And I have added comments to many of the relevant lines here where you might want to make some small changes. And of course, ChatGPT is your friend for all things code adjustment. And guess that's how I got this working for Divi. So all we're going to do here is we're going to grab this class quickly and just the DE liquid glass wrapper. We're going to copy that. And I can see I don't have that D, but that's fine. I'll type it in. And then what we're going to do is we're going to add it to the area where we want the effect. So here's my row settings. I'm going to go to the advanced tab. Now I'm going to paste that class in there. And now you can already see we've got like a blur effect going on there. Place it right here, which is our floating menu. And now you can see that effect over there as you're scrolling up and down. But something's missing, right? That displacement filter is not there. And that's that SVG code that we need to add. And you can see Divi does not love all these different things happening in the interface, but that's all good. I'm going to add another code module and then we'll go back to this article on the Divi site, Divi Engine site, and I'll just copy this SVG code. It says HTML. It's just because it's kind of formatted the same. Don't worry about that too much, but you're just going to come in here. You don't need to wrap this in anything because it's already wrapped in SVG. And just like that, you can see the distortion effect take place. So let's save this really quickly. Hop on the front end. And there we got it. We have our displacement effect. Isn't that cool? Nice. Pretty easy and quick to do. Not a great UI choice, but now you know how to do it. I did want to point out some things here in the SVG code. That's the CSS code. Here we go. Now, basically what happens is it's initially hidden and then it gets applied. And you're going to be wanting to play with some of these frequencies in the turbulence settings, or you're in the component transfer. This is where all the things are happening, where things are getting like kind of smushed up as you scroll there. I intentionally used the video as a background to show you that it works on the background video and also on the sticky section as we're moving up and down. But this is the one way of doing it. Formats liquid glass, as I said, but here is a fancier way of doing it. And this is going to be in the next video that I show you. Now, you can see this is a lot closer to what the Apple effect looks like. Even works nicely when you scroll through with video and all that fun stuff. So definitely hang around and subscribe and like if you don't like our channel yet, because why wouldn't you? There's a lot of good info here. And check out this tutorial and get notified when it drops by hitting the bell. And that's going to be it for me. Again, all the links are going to be in the description of this video. It's going to be the links to the code. It's going to be links to the inspiration for the code. And it's going to be links to the Divi Engine site, because check out Divi Engine. We're pretty good. All right, guys, that's going to be it for me, Robey, with the Divi Engine team. Bye for now.